Alright, now that you understand assembly better, we can start setting up our environment for development. While you could develop on Windows with nasm, we won't do that. It's because it's impractical. It's preferable to use an operating system like Linux. So we will set up virtual machines to do so. Now, as my virtual machine, I'm going to use VirtualBox. First off, because it's open source and it's free. Now, to download VirtualBox, I will repeat that, but all the links are going to be in the description. So, if you're on Windows, you select. If you're already on Linux, you don't need to do all of that. You just have to skip to the installation part. So, otherwise, if you're on Windows, you just click on Windows Host here, save. If they ask you to install drivers, you can click install. Alright, now we will need to download an ISO file for our Linux image. So in this series, I will be installing Ubuntu desktop for two reasons. The first one, because it's easy and accessible, and the second one, because it's reliable. So once you're on the website, you just can select the Ubuntu LTS, you click download, and it should start downloading an ISO file. Now the download of the ISO file is extremely long, so I'm obviously going to skip that part. Okay, now that you have VirtualBox and an ISO file, we can start setting up our virtual machine. Now on VirtualBox, all you do is click on new, give a name to your virtual machine. I'm going to call mine Ubuntu ASM. It really can be anything. Now for the memory, a reliable amount will be 4000 megabytes or something around that. Keep in mind that you can come back tweaking these options later on, so it's not really important, but to be usable, 4000 is just enough. You just click create, don't mind about that, dynamically allocate. And now for the disk size, it really depends on you, on how much you'll use this machine. I think 20 gigabytes is just enough. Just click create. Now, make sure you have your ISO file, because now when the machine is going to start up, it's asking you for an ISO file. It always pre-selected mine, because I already made a machine with this ISO file in the past, but otherwise you just click on the folder, add, you select your ISO file, and then you can click start. Now, after your machine is complete setting up some things, you'll be welcomed by this installer. You just click install and select your language. Then you can choose your keyboard layout, whatever. And I recommend using a minimal installation, and you don't have to select this option, it's okay like that. Now I can just click install now. Continue. You select your time zone, whatever. And you can give a name to your machine. I'll call mine Linux. And the password is very important, because we're going to use it for to execute some commands in the machine that needs more privileges. So remember your password, because it's important. You can click login automatically. It doesn't matter since it's a VM. So if you did everything correctly and you followed all the instructions it gave you, you should now be prompted with the loading Ubuntu after restarting the machine. And no worries that if there is a black screen, it's because it's loading. Alright, so now you should have this. The machine should look something like this. Whoop-a-lay. Sorry for that. Here you go. Whoop. Okay. Alright, so now we're going to be ready to start installing the actual software. Alright, so now to install the tools, once you're prompted, you just click skip and next. You can click no, but whatever. Done. And yeah, it's gonna be annoying. Alright. You can open up a terminal. And the first thing we're going to do is type sudo apt update. Those two characters, sudo apt upgrade. Now you will need to type your password we entered earlier. Remember that. Don't worry about sudo, it's a command that basically allows us to execute things that requires more privileges. But don't worry, you don't have to always input your password each time it saves it and remember your session, quote unquote. Sometimes it's going to prompt you, do you want to continue? You just press enter or yes, and it's going to proceed with the installation. All the commands I'm going to type right now are in the description, so you can just copy them or and paste them. It might not work to copy and paste, so you might have to type them manually, but yeah. Alright, now that we finished upgrading our packages and updating the dependencies, we can start installing the actual tools we'll use to program or compile our code, yeah. So you'll type sudo and you can just copy and paste my command, but it's apt install. We will install binutils, nasm, gdb, radar2 actually, and vim. Now for this part, vim is not that important. You might or might not need it because you will choose your own IDE later. But for now, that's the command. And now once this is installed, we're done. See you in the next video.